Hello, the math dog here. In this video, I will be deriving the area of a circle by integrating concentric rings. This is a calculus video. So for starters, let's look at the parts of a circle again, review that. So the diameter of a circle is a line segment or chord that goes right through the center of the circle such that it touches the circle in two points. Okay, and then a radius is the distance from the center to the center of the circle to a point on the circle, and it is half a diameter. So 2 times radius is equal to diameter. The circumference of the circle is 1 lap around the circle, or the distance around the circle 1 time. If you roll the circle 1 revolution, the distance that you rolled would be the circumference. So all circles are similar figures. And in similar figures, all corresponding parts are in the same or equal ratios. So if I have 2 circles, say this is circle 1, circle 2, and circle 1, since all circles are similar, we know the ratio of the circumference to the diameter in circle 1 is equal to the ratio of the circumference to diameter in circle 2, which is some constant k. In the Common Core curriculum, this is often called the constant of proportionality. But in particular, in the case of circles, this ratio of circumference to diameter is given this name pi. It's called pi. Pi is the ratio of circumference to diameter. It is, again, here I've written it out right there. Okay, so once you have this, c divided by d is equal to this number pi, which is the constant of the ratio between circumference and diameter. And again, we know that it's always going to be this number pi because these are similar, because circles, all circles are similar, therefore their corresponding parts are in the same proportional ratio. So once again, c sub 1 to d sub 1 has to equal c sub 2 to d sub 2. If you had a third circle, c sub 3 would be to d sub 3 as c sub 2 is to d sub 2, etc., etc., etc. So from this formula, you can write, by cross multiplying, you can write c is pi times diameter. Since the diameter is 2 times radius, you can write c is pi times 2r. So by rearranging the things you're multiplying here, you get c is 2 pi r. So c equals pi d and c equals 2 pi r. These follow directly from the definition of the circle. So you can do like some very interesting, intricate calculus proofs, and I've done it myself, where you're using, like, you're integrating arc length to get the circumference of a circle. But then in that proof, you're going to have to use like arc sine or arc cosine. But those things rely on the value of pi. And pi, it's circular reasoning because you're using pi to get pi. So that's faulty reasoning. So again, these just follow strictly from the circumference of the definition of pi, which is the ratio of circumference to diameter. Now, if you want to estimate the value of pi, that's another thing. Probably the most famous one was done over 2,000 years ago by Archimedes. And basically that idea, he started with a hexagon. Basically, this isn't exactly what he did by any means, but basically he kept increasing the number of sides on a polygon until it looked very much like a circle. In fact, I think he did 96 polygons. So the thing is, you have a polygon inscribed or inside of a circle, and as you increase the number of sides, that polygon looks more and more like a circle. So your estimate of what the circumference is should get better and better. And that's a different thing. I'm just saying pi is some number here that is the ratio of circumference and diameter. So let's go to our proof. All right, let's get to the proof here. So we're gonna find the area formula for a circle by integrating concentric rings. So concentric circles are circles that have a common center. So the concentric ring has a little thickness here. Let's take this one right here. This will be the ith concentric ring, radius x sub I, thickness delta x sub I, and I'm calling the circumference of this ring c sub x sub I, because c is actually a function of x. We know that because c is 2 pi r, or in this case 2 pi x sub I. So it's not, c is not actually a constant. Okay, it will change also. It's based on the value of x. So if I take, I have this ring, I take some scissors and I cut it right here, say, take some scissors, I cut the ring, I flatten it, I get this. So the thickness or the height of this, this is gonna now be a rectangle, is delta x sub I, and the base of this ring, the length of the base, is c of x sub I, because it's the circumference. Okay, so what we're doing then is we're adding up all these concentric rings as we go out from 0 to r, and that'll give us an approximation to the area of circle. So the area of circle is approximately the sum from I equals 1 to n of c of x sub I times delta x sub I, because the area of a rectangle is base times height, which is what we have right here. This is base times height. So note again now that c of x sub I is in fact the circumference, where the radius is x sub I, is going to be 2 pi x sub I, and that follows again from our definition. Follows from our definition of pi, which is c divided by d, which is also then pi is equal then to c over 2r, because radius 2r, 2 radius is diameter, and you cross multiply and you get c equals 2 pi r. And that's where this is coming from. So c of x sub I is to be 2 pi times x sub I, where x sub I is the radius of the ith circle. Okay, so now we can make a substitution, replacing c of x sub I with 2 pi of x sub I. So the area of circle is approximately the sum from I equals 1 to n of 2 pi x sub I times delta x sub I. So now we're going to increase the number of concentric circles or rings. Really, probably should use the word ring. Rings to infinity. Okay, notice as we do that, as n gets bigger and bigger, delta x sub I is going to get thinner and thinner, and it's going to get infinitesimally small. So the area of circle then, we actually can say the actual area of circle is the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum of I equals 1 to n times, area of circle is the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum of I equals 1 to n of 2 pi times x sub I times delta x sub I, okay? So we have, here it is again. So now we can change this to an integral, because this is the definition of an integral. We're going to use the definition of integral to write the integral. An integral is an infinite sum, and that's what we have here. So we're actually integrating from 0 to r, the function 2 pi x dx. Delta x sub I becomes dx, and when we have an infinite sum of x sub I, we just write 2 pi x here. So now I can factor out the constant 2 pi, and then I'm just going to integrate this. So I've got 2 pi, and then the antiderivative of x is going to be x squared over 2, and I'm evaluating from 0 to r. Okay, so notice now that the 2's here cancel, so I have pi x squared evaluated from 0 to r. So this then is pi, replace x with the upper limit of r, so that's r squared, minus replace x with 0, which is the lower limit. So we have this. This is just r squared. So we have pi r squared. And that's what we're trying to show here. The area of a circle is pi r squared. And this is the end of the proof here. So I hope it was helpful. If you found this video informative and you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, The Math Dawg. You may share the content of this video with others. Thank you and have a good day.